Hey, how's it going, everybody? John Wick here with the 31-day challenge for December 9th, 2020. And today, we're going to be making a character for Traveler. I used to have the little black box. I don't have it anymore, and it makes me sad. But I'm also very happy with the newest version of Traveler. Traveler is a far future role-playing game, and it is my go-to when I get my Mass Effect itch. Mass Effect is much more soft sci-fi than Traveler is. I hate genre. So I hate calling things hard science fiction and soft science fiction or space opera or anything like that. But there's a lot of science in Traveler, and that's one of the things that I like about it. When I do science fiction, when I get the science fiction itch, I want science in there. I agree with Neil deGrasse Tyson that one of my favorite science fiction, as a matter of fact, my favorite science fiction movie is The Martian because of all the science in it. And I'm really bad at science, actually. It was not one of the disciplines that I was good at, but I love it in such much the same way that I really love math. And it just has never been kind to me. But I love Traveler. And one of the reasons I love Traveler is because it introduced me to the idea of life paths in role-playing games. In Traveler, you start with a character who's 18 years old. And in the newest edition, you choose to either go into the military or go into education or to get a higher education. And there's a lot of random generation in Traveler, including random stat generation, which really irks me, but I'm going to make a character according to the way the rules are written. So I rolled for my stats. It could have been better. And starting at 18, with that education or military background, you then go on to pick different careers. You can have an espionage career. You can have a drifter career. You can have an academic career. You can go into the Navy, the Army, or any of the other military branches. You can do all of these different things, and each step costs you 4 years, which means that your character ages in a real way. You start with an 18-year-old character and you end up with someone who is much older because age is part of character creation. Which means in Traveler, you get a really rich sense of who your character has been up to the point where you start playing them. Original versions of Traveler had a push-your-luck mechanic, which is now famous, that I still adore, even though it's crazy. There is no reason. There is no logical reason for me to love this mechanic, but I do. When you end the 4 years of a career, you can choose to extend it. You can push your luck. And the more you push your luck, the more benefits you get out of a career. And you can switch careers too, but if you do, you aren't building up those benefits of having a single career throughout your life. And some careers are more dangerous than others, which means that there's survival rolls. Yes, you roll to see if your character survives their 4 years in that chapter of their career. If you pick less dangerous careers, there's a higher chance of surviving. And if you pick more dangerous careers, such as military career or a criminal career, there's a lot of rewards to be had, but there's also the real good chance that your character will die in character creation. Do not ask me why I love this. I think it is awesome. And in the new Traveler, there is not a lot of chance for that to happen. There's a very, 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 very small chance of it happening. What's more likely to happen is that your character will get injured or get sent to prison or some other consequence that has a detrimental effect on your character. The new system for Traveler is just like it used to be in old Traveler, which is you roll 2d6, and your stats give you bonuses, kind of like the way that in the sense that everybody's familiar with D&D, in the sense that the higher your stat is, the bigger a bonus it gives you. So stats like 8 will give you a bonus of +0, by stats like 13 will give you a bonus of +2, and so you add your bonus or your DM to the roll, and then that determines whether you succeed or not based on a target number. The whole Traveler universe is huge. Mark's been writing, and other people have been writing about the Traveler universe for a very long time. It was one of the very first role-playing games, and because of that, there's a lot of stuff, lots of stuff that you can find in the Traveler universe. There are a whole lot of published adventures or campaigns for role-playing games, and one of my favorites is The Pirates of Drinax, and this is The Pirates of Drinax. It is huge, and it has a whole book on the Trojan Reach, which is one of the places that you can adventure, and it is a whole book on the Trojan Reach. It's great setting material, gives you advanced character options, all that kind of stuff, and then there is the actual campaign. And like most adventures, I took and plundered it. I plundered it for ideas and essentially made my own campaign. But it's so full of good ideas that if you're into semi-hard science fiction, and Traveler is one of the hardest science fiction games that you'll find, I think The Pirates of Drinax is something that you should probably take a peek at. This is my character, and this is the background information that I generated for him. His name is Servo Focal, and he's human. He is from the planet of Senet 7, which is a planet that I created using the planet creation rules that are in the Traveler core book. World size 2, it has a thin atmosphere with large oceans, a small population, about 1 million people. It's got a temperate climate. The government is a non-charismatic leader with 2 powerful factions that are striving for control, a liberal faction and a deceptive faction. I imagine the deceptive faction is probably the monarchy that controls the planet. There's a lot of monarchies running around in the Traveler universe. All weapons and armor are illegal, except for the law. It has a routine starport, and the ruling class is very, very, very rich. And the ruling class is where my character comes from, because I have an 11 social skill. These are the numbers that I rolled for my character. I rolled an 8, an 8, an 11, a 10, a 7, and a 5. And so I have an 8 strength, an 8 dexterity, a 5 endurance, an 8 intellect, a 13 education, and an 11 social. I got the 13 education because my character went to school, and at the end of that term, you muster out. One of the benefits is you get a +2 education. So as for Foucault's career, he started off as a noble, which means he was a dilettante noble. He got the carouse skill, and I got a life event, which was I got +2 DM on any roll in my future career. So I saved that till the very, very end, and you'll see why. So from after taking noble, I decided to take agent. Like I said, the world I come from, Senet 7, is ruled by 2 factions, one of whom is deceptive and one of them is liberal. Let me get my hair out of my face. One of whom is deceptive and the other is liberal. I think the deceptive is the ruling class, the monarchy, and the liberal is the underclass that's trying to overthrow the monarchy. And he became an agent to infiltrate the lower class and try to sabotage it from taking over the planet. In other words, Mr. Focal was not a very nice guy. From that, I got stealth, and I gained 2 contacts. I took a second career in agent, so this is my 3rd career now. I had 1 career in noble, I took 1 career in agent, my 2nd career in agent. I took intel, I got 2 more points in deception, I got a point in streetwise and undercover. But I rolled an awful tragedy thing on my event, and I got sent to prison. So I take that as the very rich faction has overtaken the liberal faction has overtaken the deceptive faction. And because I was in prison for 4 years, I acted as a fixer, and I got more deception. I got so much deception. I got melee unarmed because I learned how to use a knife. And for my mustering out, I got that plus two. I actually was part of the event. I was part of an attempt to break out of the prison, and I did. And so I got to roll on another table, and because of that table, I added two to that, and I managed to get 100,000 credits and a yacht. So I got a small ship out of it. So I got really lucky. I got really lucky with Foucault. And he's got a lot of admin, a lot of advocate, a lot of deception, a whole lot of deception, some streetwise, some medic, and some other things. And he's got a small ship. And boy, does he sound like a lot of fun to play. Again, with a small ship, that means that I can either sell it or to help buy a bigger ship with my other players, or we can use my ship as kind of a base of operations, because I highly suspect that chances are we may become pirates. And that is my character for December 9th, 2020. Traveler, it's a fun game, lots and lots. If you like to dive into setting stuff, there is a whole ton of setting stuff for you to dive into in Traveler, and I highly recommend doing so. In the meantime, wash your hands, wear a mask, take care of each other, and